Hello and welcome back to Firewatch. So last time, let me think, if we are heading down to the lake to investigate a quote-unquote bear, but as we soon approach, we find something much different. Let's take a look.
What the, I found a clipboard down here and there's something strange going on.
At the lake? What's up?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo?
Buckaroo? Oh,
I don't know why I just called you that.
Jesus. Okay. And say
Henry,
it. I expected
are
that.
Are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone. You know, somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Well, that certainly is a surprise. So who attacked us? Why are they listening into our conversations? You know, there seems to be a great mystery. And as you can see now, we've jumped quite a bit as well. It's now day 76. So, again, if you do see the clipboard, it's like our conversations are getting more friendly. She called me Buckaroo. I don't know. It's just weird to me. Alright, so jumping to the fence now, we have a look around, and there is a, a gate or a door. So Delilah suggests that we go see, some of the firefighters down, in their camp who are fighting against controlling the burn of the June fire. So we'll have to make our way there.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence. I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that If anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
All right, so as you approach the camp, the bridge is out, and you have to find a way around.
You're
there? Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s. Wow, 99% sure that's for burying poop.
And I'm holding it.
Maybe drop it?
I'm still holding it. Why am I still holding it?
Now that's a real mystery.
Well, we didn't find the workers or firefighters. We did find this document, and it does mention a Wapiti station. So we decide to take things, or take matters into our own hands, and grab, I believe there's an axe or hatchet around here, and we head back to the fence.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires. Just on my way back, in and out of trees in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this.
Hello?
Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
What about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Hmm. Wait, what? I thought we were at day 90-something.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today.
The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion.
Alright, so this is just the next day, which, you know, when I was playing the game, I lost track of which day I was at. So when it jumped one day, it had the same effect of jumping, I don't know, 30 days or whatever the long jumps was, which was kind of awkward because then you lose track of how many days have gone by from the last jump. So I think maybe if it kind of like flipped like from the number, so if it was going from 76 to 77, it just flipped instead of just a hard cut, you would realize, oh, it's the next day, rather than, holy shit, it's been 26 days, you know what I mean? Anyway, so Delilah has set up a plan for us to retrieve a new radio. So we'll have to go retrieve the radio from the Dropbox.
Tree in the top row, second from the left.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
Okay, so we break ourselves into Wapiti Station.
No, screw it.
And as we approach to the center, we'll soon find out what this whole place is all about.
I don't know. I feel like they're going to go down this road of like, oh my god, there's a huge conspiracy. And then the twist is that it's not a huge conspiracy. They're just like studying the weather. That's what I'm thinking. It could be more than that, though. Could be totally wrong.
Inside the camp now, you hear a beeping, you can see a flashing light. There's a bunch of stuff that you can kind of report back to Delilah, but the main thing here is you want that wave receiver. This device, I guess, detects electrical waves. radio waves. We pick it up and it leads you to another little device or box.
Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy. I think this thing is responding to something in this pile of crap on the desk.
Dig through it.
Oh. What? Yeah, it's odd.
What? What is it?
There's a folder of reports here.
What? Henry, do you hear me?
It says that you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah, okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it. Worst case scenario...
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am, and I think it's insane.
Well, as we're leaving Wapiti Station, the bridge collapses behind us, and surprise, surprise, the whole camp is set on fire. Well, you can probably assume that the person that's doing this is the same person that knocked us out and is following us for whatever reason. And we decide to call it in, take care of the fire. That's a responsible thing to do.
This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
We use our newfangled device here, the wave receiver, to track down whatever it's leading us to.
Maybe the medicine wheel?
Shit! What?
Oddly enough, this book bag contains the key to the cave, which I don't know if I showed that off, but there's a locked gate in the cave, and Delilah said the key was lost, and it turns up on this backpack that was tracked with the wave receiver and alarmed as well. I guess the only... Our next step here is, you know, we gotta go investigate that cave.
Who the hell took him?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going. I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
It's a tape of us talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
D, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my god, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Oh my god. Going to that cave for sure.
Okay, so here in the cave, here in my cave, I'm trying to use the key, and then Henry just keeps running into the freaking door.
What do I do?
There you go. It eventually fixed itself. As we get into the cave here, we get locked in, but we eventually do find ourselves a way out.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave. Is this thing working? Delilah, send someone to the cave, please! Ooh, damn reception. Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus! Delilah, I just found an outcropping that...
Well, as it turns out, Brian Goodwin made himself a little sanctuary, turns out. There's various items around here he can look through and have a little banter back and forth with Delilah. But after that, we gotta keep moving on. We still haven't really solved anything of a mystery yet, I suppose.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
So, in the little alcove that Brian Goodwin had, he also had climbing gear. So we head back into the cave, and we climb down the... It was a big slope. We climbed down, and inside the cave, we discover something. Yeah, I had a feeling I'd find something like this down here.
Gave out. Oh, you poor fucking kid. Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Hey, you, might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident. I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No, I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Day 79. And as we begin this day, that June fire is still going on. Seems to be getting a little worse. It shifts around, right? The wind is blowing and howling. We need to get out of here.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
That's so where I'm from. Happens to me. Once again, we used a wave receiver to track down an electrical device here. There's a collar, which I think is supposed to, like, represent our dog? I think. Oh, it's a tracking collar. Okay. Let me take the tape here. And, let's give her a listen.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
That's right. Big old bad Ned. Just been hiding around. And I would believe that Delilah didn't know that Ned killed his son. But I guess there's a theory that she knew Ned was out here. And she was in on the whole ordeal. Again, I'll have to link that in the video description below. Anyway, you can rummage around his things and look around.
He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
Henry, you're tired. There's nothing big going on. They'll come back for you.
Just wait.
I'm gonna go.
Okay. If you have to.
I have to. Hike safe.
All right, so anyway, we have to make a journey up to Delilah's tower and get the hell out of here.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
Maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
Burn. Rejected.
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I, yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Would you?
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
She won't even recognize me, Delilah.
Yes.
You're not just going for her.
You don't know what it's like.
Bad things happen, okay? And you have to find a way to contain the damage. A good way.
Well, hopefully I can figure out a way to do that.
Yeah, I hope so.
God, this got dark.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
There's the helicopter.
Good. They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
You keep it for yourself. Bye, Hank.
Bitch. Just kidding. I don't get it. I don't get this game, actually. I don't get it anymore. Henry really seemed determined in moving on. Delilah's like, nah, do it. Just sit there and never go home. Maybe the helicopter will crash. Like, this was a mediocre story with a fairly polished video game on top of it.